Hello guys, this is Sonia Peterson with Life by Design Realty Group, powered by Realty One Group Edge. So I get to work with a lot of first-time home buyers. They're actually my favorite. But when we first sit down to have that initial consultation, their first question is, how much money am I going to need? So I thought I would just give a quick video on what to expect in regards to out-of-pocket expenses. So number one, you'll need a down payment. Down payments, typically, if you're going FHA, expect it to be 3.5% of the purchase price. If you're going conventional, it may vary. 2%, 3%, 5%, 10%. It all depends. And if you are an investor, you can look to pay 20% down. Also, earnest money. Earnest money is almost like a good faith deposit. It really lets the seller know that you're interested in purchasing their home. Earnest money, usually about 1% down, but I will tell you we are in a seller's market. So sometimes in order to sweeten the pot or make your offer stand out, you may want to put more down than 1%. Next is appraisal. So the lender is going to order an appraisal because they want to make sure that the home is valued for at least what they are lending you. And appraisal costs normally $525, $625, somewhere around there. Next, inspection, because you don't want to buy a house that you do not get an inspection for. Don't do that. Inspections typically run about $450 or more, depending upon the size of the house. And you also have your closing cost. Closing costs are 3 to 4% of the purchase price of the home. Closing costs consist of lender fees, attorney fees, tax prorations, your HOA prorations. You also have your owner's title insurance, the lender's title insurance. And yes, you heard me right. You do pay for the lender's title insurance as well. Now, sometimes you can get sellers to contribute towards your closing cost, but I will tell you, we are in a seller's market, so don't expect to get much help with closing costs in the market that we're in today. Now, if you are lucky enough to get a down payment assistance program, then you may not have to pay 3.5% down or 2% down. But in these COVID times, even those down payment assistance programs are few and far between. So just a quick idea of what to expect when you are looking to purchase your first home. Thanks for tuning in. Look for me tomorrow where I will come back on Wednesday and give you Wednesday's word of the day. Thanks for tuning in and thanks for all your support. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.